phase contrast microscopy, a method used to observe transparent or semi-transparent objects, unstained pathology sections, sperm, microorganisms, and live cells. Today we're going to talk about phase contrast technique, microscope setup, and alignment. My name is Eric and I'm a specialist in microscopy. Let's get started. First things first, the physics of the process. Let's remember the wave theory of light, very simplistic. It's important for this episode. We can define any wave by only three parameters: amplitude, wavelength, and phase. Our eye can distinguish amplitude because amplitude is equivalent to brightness. The greater the amplitude, the greater the brightness, and vice versa. And we can also sense different wavelengths, the most important parameter that determines the color of light. The human eye can clearly see colors between violet and red, but of course there are invisible wavelengths such as ultraviolet or infrared light, radio waves, electron beams, and so on. But today we'll focus on the visible spectrum. So in microscopy, the contrast is difference in intensity, amplitude, or a difference in color, wavelength. Unfortunately, our eye can't see the phase difference. We cannot determine the phase of the light wave, so the phase contrast technique is a tricky thing that changes the phase difference to a difference in amplitudes. Let me show you what do we need and how it works. It's simple and inexpensive to adapt your upright or inverted microscope for phase contrast. Only two components need to be installed. The first one is the phase contrast condenser. It can be a special universal condenser, phase slider, or a special module to your Abbe condenser, like in my case. And the second one, phase contrast objective or objectives, if you need this method on different magnifications. By the way, almost all phase objectives have green markings. The phase ring number is also indicated. Here we have 10x magnification lens with a PH1 mark and 20x lens for the second phase ring, PH2. Phase contrast microscopy translates small changes in the phase into changes in amplitude, which are then seen as difference in image contrast. Unstained specimens that do not absorb light are called phase objects because they slightly affect the phase of the light diffracted by the specimen, usually by retarding such light approximately quarter wavelengths as compared to the undeviated direct light passing through or around the specimen unaffected. So first we need to install the phase ring in the condenser to create a hollow cone of light. The refractive index of our sample will be different from the refractive index of air, so we will have two kinds of light rays. The first, zeroth, is direct light, and the second is light diffracted by the sample and shifted by a quarter of wavelength. To speed up the direct undeviated zeroth order light, we need the phase shifter in the back focal plane of the objective. Phase shifter is a plate with narrow area optically thinner than the rest of the plate. As a result, we have background light shift for a quarter wavelength, which in total gives a difference of half a wavelength between diffracted and zeroth order light in an image plane. Because the undeviated light of the zeroth order is much brighter than the faint diffracted light, a thin ND filter is deposited on the ring to bring the direct and diffracted light into better balance of intensity in order to increase contrast. Now we can see the amplitude changing based on the interference between these rays. And as we discussed before, amplitude changing is visible for our eyes. Let's set up our microscope for phase contrast, step by step. First, Köhler illumination. If you need to know more information about Köhler illumination setup, please check the video on my channel. The main point is to adjust the condenser coaxial with the objective and in the right focus plane. Put the phase objective in the light path and install corresponding phase ring in the condenser. Remove the eyepiece or change it with a special telescope. It's a special eyepiece with a focus plane exactly on the phase ring. Using hexagon wrenches, adjust the phase ring in the condenser coaxial with the phase shifter in the objective. Done! Now your phase contrast image is perfect and your microscope is ready for acquisition. Want to learn more about microscopy? Here's a video on how to improve your image quality in 10 easy steps. See you in the future episodes. Bye.